Hi friends, today I'm going to talk about actions of dopamine in our brain. Even though dopamine exerts various effects in various tissues in our body, I'm going to focus only dopamine actions inside our brain and also related medicines, actions and side effects. Okay, I have listed four places, main places in the brain where you can see some important effects of dopamine. First one is mesolimbic system. Mesolimbic system involves in schizophrenia and psychosis. In schizophrenia and psychosis, you can see increased levels of dopamine inside this mesolimbic system. In addition to that, some drug abusers develop psychotic symptoms. Drugs such as cocaine and marijuana can increase the levels of dopamine inside the mesolimbic system, because mesolimbic system has the reward center inside. Reward center means when this center gets stimulated, people get the euphoria, ecstasy and joy. Okay, when you go to basal ganglia, as you all know, in substantia nigra, the reduced production of dopamine can lead to Parkinson's disease. Third one is hypothalamus. In hypothalamus, increased dopamine activity reduces the prolactin level. When we have low dopamine in hypothalamus, we can have more prolactin and galactorrhea, increase milk production. And the fourth one is vomiting center in the medulla. When we inhibit the vomiting center by using some drugs, you can get anti-emetic effects. That means vomiting can be stopped by inhibiting dopamine in vomiting center. Now we look at the drugs which has effects on those system. First, mesolimbic system. In schizophrenia and acute psychosis, we use neuroleptics such as haloperidol, clozapine, risperidone. These neuroleptics inhibit the dopamine inside the mesolimbic system. So when we use neuroleptics, it not only inhibit dopamine in mesolimbic system, but also it inhibit all the other places. So when we give neuroleptics, we can get side effects like Parkinson symptom, drug induced Parkinsonism, because it goes and inhibit the dopamine in substantia nigra. In addition to that, when the neuroleptic inhibit the dopamine in hypothalamus, it can produce galactorrhea and increase prolactin and gynecomastia. And in the vomiting center, neuroleptics can go and inhibit the dopamine and produce very good antiemesis. So neuroleptics are very good anti-emetic drugs. In basal ganglia, we can use levodopa and carbidopa like medicine against Parkinsonism. These medicines, when you use these medicine against Parkinsonism, that can produce if psychosis, psychotic symptom when it exert their effects in mesolimbic system. This is the side effects of carbidopa and levodopa. Regarding hypothalamus, in hypothalamus sometimes we get prolactin secreting adenomas, so that produce so much prolactin. So in order to reduce the prolactin, we use dopamine agonist such as bromocriptine and carbagolin like medicines, which increase the effects of dopamine inside the hypothalamus, by which reduce the prolactin level. At last, the vomiting center, there are some famous antiemetic drugs such as metoclopramide and domperidone. These act on vomiting center and reduce the dopamine level, block the dopamine there and produce the very good antiemetic effect. You may have seen that there are mothers with newborn babies sometimes have low breast milk production. In those patients, we used to give metoclopramide or domperidone in order to increase the milk production. How? These medicine go and inhibit the dopamine inside the hypothalamus and produced galactorrhea there and more milk production. So we used to give temporarily those metoclopramide and domperidone to those mothers. In addition to that, if you use long term, that means chronic use of metoclopramide and domperidone can lead to Parkinson-like diseases too. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Leave your comments.